Brought to you by
Eaton Detroit Spring, proudly made in the USA.
Classic car or muscle car, we want to show you how to restore your automobile and save yourself some money in the process. Sometimes we consult the pros, sometimes we mess up. But just remember, it's never a problem, it's always a project.
Right now on Auto Resto Mod, Jeff and Cam explore just how sucky an alignment shop can be and show you how cool Quick Trick is.
Honey, what are you doing out there?
Waiting on the next Super Blowout 3-day only mega sale.
You don't need a sale. You need NPD.
NPD's everyday prices are competitive with most sales, and orders arrive fast from our four strategically located superstores. National Parts Depot has quality parts for Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, GTO, Firebird, Ford, and Chevy truck. For your free catalog, go online or call toll-free.
Working beats waiting.
Sounds like it's running pretty good.
It runs great.
Oh, yeah?
It just drives like crap.
Do you have experience with that?
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, I've driven your car, so... I have a lot of experience with cars that drive like crap. This has an RRS front suspension on it. It shouldn't be handling the way it handles, and I think it boils down to the alignment I've gotten on this car. I've done it twice, and both times have been wrong. So I think third time's a charm.
That's what they say.
Yeah, we're going to go with a product that I found on Facebook, incredibly, from the guys at Quick Trick. They make an alignment system that you can do at home. Tired of dealing with these guys that don't know how to align aftermarket suspension systems. Yeah. So I'm going to do a thing on the Quick Trick this week, show the guys how to use the product, and tell them that it's actually kind of viable when I've already spent $160 on alignments that don't work. Mm. Okay, so doing your own home alignment. Well, some guys will tell you that's kind of a real pain, it's hard to do, you don't want to mess with it. But with what I've been running into in our small town that we have here in South Carolina is that most of the places that do alignments don't like dealing with anything older than stuff in the middle 80s. Some of them don't even have the information in their machines to deal with cars built back in the 60s. I went to two alignment locations before I finally found one that I thought could handle the 67. Now, admittedly, this place did a pretty good job on our 69 Fairlane, but this one really buffaloed them, mostly because the system on the car was not stock. We are running an RRS front suspension on this car that is basically a system off of an 04 GTO. So, they did it twice, wrong both times. I got fed up. As I said before, on Facebook, I found these guys at Quick Trick and decided that I would give them a shot. And they were nice enough to send us the top-of-the-line system that they offer. It's a 90097 system, and that basically is everything from this part of the table all the way over to the end. This is all the accoutrement you're going to need to do an alignment on your car. These are the pins that you use to set it up on the wheels, the tape measures you'll use to do your toe, and these are the levels that you'll use to set up both your camber and your caster. The guys at Quick Trick have just now introduced these alignment plates, and basically the plates are so that you can set up the caster on the car a little easier than just doing it on the concrete on the floor. We'll show you how to do that in just a minute. These plates are set up so that you can mark them in the center and then go over to the 20 degrees left and 20 degrees right a little easier than doing it on the concrete floor. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go and I'm going to start talking to you about what all the different things we're going to be speaking about today are. For instance, toe, caster, and camber. Going to do that right now. Okay, so I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the different things that you're going to deal with on your alignment. Basically, you have three things that are going to be your biggest issues on the alignment. It's going to be caster, camber, and toe end. I'm going to tell you what those things are and how they can affect the front end of your car. The first one I'm going to go over is caster, because 60s-era muscle cars, they really didn't believe in a whole lot of caster on these cars. Most of them were anywhere from zero to plus one-half, or at the very most, one or two. And that can create a really nice thing if you're trying to run a manual steer car, and it can be hideous if you're trying to run a power steering car on one of these early muscle cars that had the slave cylinder style system that the Mustang, Fairlane, Corvette, and some of those other cars carried. Integral systems, that's not as big a problem, but on these cars, it really can be an issue. You want, in a power steering car particularly, as much caster as you can get your hands on. Now, on this particular car, we run into kind of a problem. With the RRS front suspension that we have on here, they're requesting about 3 to 4 degrees of positive caster on the front end of the car. if you run a lot of caster on some of these wheel and tire packages, what you can end up with doing is running into the front edge of the fender here on these cars on a turn-in situation. And that's what was going on with this when we were running a lot of caster on it. We were running into a problem of running into the front fender. So we're going to have to be very careful when we change the caster on this thing, if we so choose to do. We may check the caster and be happy with what they put on it at the alignment shop and leave that alone. But know that the more caster you can throw in there to a point, the better feeling the car will be. It'll feel less like it's nervous, less like it's up on stilts trying to go down the road. It'll feel more planted with a little more caster in it. Now, the next thing I'm going to talk to you about is camber, and I'm going to pull a wheel in there to do that. Yes, I know, this is a Space Saver spare, but it'll give the points that I need to make here. The next thing I'm going to talk about is camber. Now, camber is really kind of effective when your suspension is going through its range of motion. When it's going up and down on the undulations of the road, your suspension system on 99% of the stuff you're going to run into from the mid-60s is going to change. It's going to either camber out or camber in, depending on the style of suspension you have. So on something like this, where we're running this front suspension that's basically the same thing as the 04 GTO, this one requires about a quarter of a degree of negative camber. Now, you have positive camber and you have negative camber. Most of your cars from back in the day are going to want zero camber, but some of them will require different camber settings. You just need to look at the alignment specs that the guys at Quick Trick offer if you're using their system to do your alignment, and that'll tell you what the original stuff was supposed to be. Anytime you're dealing with an aftermarket suspension system, you're going to want to go with whatever their alignment specs are on your car. If they're calling for a quarter to a half degree or even 1 degree of negative camber, like this, you're going to want to go in and make sure you put negative camber on the front end of the car. If they're calling for positive camber, again, you need to put positive camber on the car. Now, the next thing I'm going to mention on this is toe. When you're working on one of these classic cars, most of the time, people are going to ask for a little bit of toe in on the front of the car. Now, let's look at this from the aspect that this is the back of the car and this is the front of the car. Whenever I say that you want positive toe, this is positive toe. And then you also can have negative toe. Some of them might require that. Again, follow your alignment specifications. Now, the guys from RRS want about a 16th of an inch of positive toe on this. And the reason you want a little bit of toe in on the front of the car is it's going to make it track and handle a little bit better, especially if you're running stock steering components. The problem you run into with classic cars is you have a steering box that goes to a pitman arm, that goes to a drag link, that goes to a idler arm, that goes down to tie rod ends, that go onto the spindles. Lost motion is not going to be your friend. And putting a little bit of positive toe in on the front of the car is going to alleviate that and cause that to, in essence, slightly tighten up. Now, the only thing that you can run into with toe is you can run into a little bit more tire wear if you start going into running more than a 16th of an inch of toe. Most manufacturers on classic cars were asking for a 16th to an 8th inch of toe. You just kind of have to keep in mind of, as I said, going out and checking the Quick Trick charts that they offer after you buy one of their alignment systems to be able to go in and know what you're supposed to run with a factory alignment. Aftermarket systems, as I said, all bets are off. If you run a rack and pinion, they may not want any toe in on it at all. Please be sure when you're doing an alignment to go out and check what the manufacturer says about your particular car and their particular product with an alignment. So, from here on, we're going to start putting this thing together and show you how to line the front of the car. All right, one of the first things I want to do here is I want to establish that we've got the front end fairly straight. So what we're going to do is push the car forward and pull it back a couple of times just to make sure that the tires are running straight on the car. This car's already had an alignment, so we're not working from scratch here. It's not a great alignment, but it is an alignment. So we're going to go ahead and do that and push this thing up a little bit. One more, just to make sure this thing will move at all.
I'm busy.
Now, we're going to go in, I'm going to put it in gear, I'm going to put some wheel chocks under the back wheels, and then we're going to start working on setting up for our camber and caster on this. All right, let's throw it in gear, and put some chocks in. All right, so what we're going to talk about now is the basic setup of the QuickTrick alignment system. Now, one thing I'll say is when we're talking about this system, you see this nut assembly here. This only goes into the steel of the crossbar here. There's not a nut on there, so I would be very careful about putting this on and tightening it down. You can possibly cross-thread it, so you don't want to do that, and you don't want to pull those threads out. And then the other thing I wanted to talk about is this. You're going to have two cases you're working on with alignments. You're going to have a beaded wheel like this one here. Now, this is just a space saver spare we used earlier. And then you're also going to have a wheel like the one back over here behind me on our 67 Mustang Fastback. This wheel does not have a bead on it. It's a smooth side. So when you're doing that, you've got one of two things you can do. With a beaded wheel, this piece, which is what holds this onto the wheel, actually will sit on the inside of the bead. If you're going with a beadless wheel like the one we have on the 67, they go to the outside. Now what you've got that comes with the kit on the 97 kit that we're using is you've got these caps that can be put on here, and these will work to save your wheels be either on this side or on this side. But what I found is, and what they talked about at QuickTrick, is you need to use masking tape whenever you're doing a beadless wheel like our 67 wears. And the edges on these are actually pretty sharp on both sides, so you want to not wreck your wheel. This is a good way to keep from doing that. You just put some masking tape on here and you should be good to go. This is one problem with the beadless wheels like these, though. It can create kind of a stink for you when you're trying to do this. And you'll need to do this to all three of them on both sides of the car. Now that's good to go. Now I'm going to pull this off and I'm going to go ahead and get it set up on our wheel here. I'm going to continue on with how you need to get this rolling.
All right, so I'm going to show you how to set up the caster degrees on the floor. So what you're going to want to do is get yourself a carpenter's L. Big one works better. Want to set it up, find the center line of your wheel. Looks like ours is right about there. Then get yourself a dry erase marker. Very handy in this, because it will not stay on the wheel, but you can actually see it. And then you take a carpenter's L again, go across the tire, take yourself some good masking tape, and run it the length of the carpenter's L, right up against the edge. Make sure that's stuck good to the floor, because you do not want that to move. Otherwise, your whole thing will be out of whack. Take the center point off the wheel, transfer it down to the tape. So then you get a protractor, you go to the inside of the tape, make sure it's all lined up with the tape and in the center line of the wheel, then measure out 20 degrees. And then you also take the tape, measure 20 degrees on the back side. Now this method is not the most accurate because you're, again, doing little measurements and there's a lot of variance there, but it'll get you in the ballpark.
All right, so now we're gonna be using the turn plates. Tons easier than doing the tape on the floor. While both can work, the turn plates, though more expensive, are a lot more accurate for doing your 20 degree turnouts. So our protractor is done. So now what we're gonna do is Cam's gonna reach in there, put the thing out of gear, and we're gonna roll it forward and hopefully get it about where it was at on the line we established before. The center line thing is still pretty important because it'll let you know when you're about, back up a little bit. Now what we did is we took a tape measure and measured from the underside of the tire at the center point to the back edge of the plate so that we know that both plates are in basically the same position. If your car is square, that should work just fine. The next thing I'm gonna do, now that we've got it positioned, is go in and mark my center position on the plate. The nice thing is it really doesn't matter where you're at on that plate. You mark it right before you start doing all your alignment stuff. Okay, so we got on our turn plates. Now I'm gonna show you guys how to go in and put the T-assembly on here to go in and get your caster and camber set up. Oh, and your toe as well. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set the T up on here. So you wanna try to get this thing as level as you can by looking at it. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use both of my levels. This one, I'm going to set on the ground right here where our plates are so that we know we're basically level there. I'm gonna turn it on and see what our level is. Now we're a little out of level, but this is what our level is. This is gonna be our 90 degree. So I double tap it. Now it's at zero. And it'll do that whenever you're at zero. So I'm gonna now set this on here and you can see that we're out a pretty good bit And we're actually out of level this way. I don't know if you can really see it, but there's an arrow here, and you have an up arrow and a down arrow. If it's down, it means it's out this way, going toward the back of the car. If it's out toward the other way, the arrow will be pointing up. Okay, so I'm going to try to level this and get this at this one level first. And you're working in tiny, tiny increments here. That's how tiny the increments is. Me doing that a little bit can pull it right out. Now we know we've got it level horizontally. And we're going to try, we'll loosen this up just a little bit. We're going to turn this one on. And we're at 89.20, so we know we're out a little bit. So we know that this side is pretty much good to go as far as being level. We know the car is, both tires are front, are straight toward the front. Now we need to go and do this on the other side, and obviously, I don't really need to show you that because it's the same thing just over there. All right, now what we've done is, I wasn't happy with what I was seeing on the tapes on this. It was too far out. So what they recommend is if you're unsure about it and you want to make sure that your wheels are square on your chassis, they recommend that you go in and do the string method, and that's what we set up here. What you want to do is take a couple of jack stands on either side of the car. You're going to need four to make sure you've got this thing square. You measure off of the center of your hub to the line that you've set up on both the front of the car and on the back of the car. And on ours, we're pretty good. We're at 3 inches and 3 inches here. All right, so now we've gone in and we set up the string method because the guys at Quick Trick recommend that if you've got a misalignment problem, you need to string out the car to make sure the chassis is sitting square with the tires. So what we've done is we've run the string down the side of the car. Cam, bring me that tape measure because I want to show these guys what I'm talking about.
Sure thing. Looks good over here.
Okay. So now what you want to do, folks, is you're going to want to go and set up your string along the line of the car and do a measurement to the center of your hub at the back. We are at 3 inches on the back of the wheel. We come up here to the front and we measure to the center of the hub on the front. And by gum, we're now at 3 inches. So we know that the car is sitting square. What you then want to do is go in and take a measurement on either side of the car at a solid point. Now on this car, we're measuring here off of the outside bead of the wheel up against the tape. And we are at 2 inches here and doing the same thing at the front. Up against our wire here. We're right at 2/16 of an inch, 2 1/16 of an inch. And we go to the other side and make the identical measure. Now, with that, we go to the other side and make the same measure. And on this car, we know that we're at 2 inches on the back side of the wheel and 2 1/16 on the front side of the wheel. That means we've got about 1/8 of an inch of toe. That is not great. Now, on a late model car, we may would have a problem with the wheel because a lot of those are in a lockdown position. So you have to do your changes out here in the front end. On a vintage car like this, it's a splined wheel. You don't have any knockout mark in it like you would on a late model wheel. So we can basically take that wheel off where it's sitting and sit it straight in the car now that we know that we're square in the front end. And that's what we'll do next. Now we're not gonna show you that because that's different on all the different cars, but basically you take the wheel off, center it up, and you should be good to go. All right, now we're doing what Quick Trick recommends, and basically we've done the string method. I've got my tie rod adjuster sleeve loose under here, and I'm spinning this tie rod adjuster sleeve, and Cam's gonna check the measure on there.
That's good right there.
Okay, so we got, what are we at right now? We're at, on the back?
Right now, we are at 1/16 of toe on this tire.
Okay, that's good. All right, so we're gonna go now and go to the other side and do the same thing, and we'll know now that we're basically in a decent chassis alignment with our wheels, as well as our toe, because we'll match this on the other side of the front end. All right, Cam, run to the other side, Batman.
Woo,
woo. Okay, now we've gone in and mucked about with this thing, probably spent about 45 minutes going in back and forth on the toe. We now are at the RRS factory recommended 1/16 of an inch of toe on the front end of this car. It takes a little time to do this. If you're gonna do it, you might as well do it right. So we've got this all finished now. Now we're gonna go in and start mucking about side to side with our camber. That's our next most important thing because I'm almost positive that this thing has positive camber, and at the very most, it's supposed to have 1/4 of a degree of negative camber. So that means the top of the tire should be in a little bit on the car. I want to make sure that my crossbar is 90 degree or level. Done that, and now I'm checking to make sure that my vertical bar is 90 degrees to the ground so that I can check for camber make sure I got good camber on it. So I'm going to do this. What they recommend you doing is putting the gauge down here on the floor in front of it. You know, note we're at a 0.40, so I want to zero that, double click it. All right, now we're on zero. You heard it beep, and I'm going to put this up here on the bar to check for camber. There's actually a magnet on this end of it. You'll note that we are positive 10 degrees of camber. That's not good at all. That's probably where most of my tire wear has been coming from. That and it had a quarter of an inch of toe on it. So all these things have culminated to just wear the crap out of these tires. This is why the problem I'm having with this alignment, because the guy at the alignment shop said he put it where it was best according to the machine. And this is why this system comes in so smacking good on classic cars, because you can set it up exactly how you want it. All right, now what I'm going to do is, I'm not going to show you how to do this because it's an aftermarket system that doesn't align like a stock Mustang. Camber would be adjusted fairly simply, actually, underneath the car on the inside next to the engine mounts on a 67 Mustang, but alas, not on this car. This car uses the 04 GTO type system. One more thing I wanted to go into. The cool thing about these levels is they do have a timeout on them. If they blank out while you're working, you can go in and hit the on-off switch, but I'm not sure how long they'll hold out for that. So if you're in the middle of working and it blanks out, don't freak out, because you can go in and actually tap it again and it'll come right back up, okay? So we're gonna get this stuff done underneath the car and we'll come back. All right, we're about to button this thing up. We're gonna do our caster as a final on this. We're gonna basically take and follow the instructions. They want you to turn the wheels out 20 degrees. So Cam, go ahead and turn that wheel out to the passenger side. Good, back a little bit. Just a hair. Come on, one more, right there. Okay, now you're supposed to zero your gauge here. Okay, the gauge is zeroed. All right, Cam, go back out to 20 degrees positive. There. Okay, we're at 2.10. Cam, we're supposed to multiply that by 1.5. I am no mathematician whatsoever, but he has a phone. Goodness, or we would be here all night. All right, Cam, with all that ado, what's the number?
The number is 3.15 degrees.
We are well within our reach. On the RRS front suspension, they recommend anywhere from 3 to 4 degrees of caster. We're going to go in now and do the other side. We're going to do that off camera, and then we're going to come back and button this bad boy up. Well, Cameroon, I think we got her done.
I hope so.
Well, we're not really done, but we found out all the problems. Thing. We had a camber issue on this side. The toe was too much. This side, the caster is out to 5 degrees. That side, the caster is at 3 degrees. Jiminy Christmas.
How much did you say you paid for that?
I didn't even get kissed, and I paid 80 bucks for it. Yeah, you know, sometimes those kind of things happen. But it actually prompted us to get this. And I think for what we do around here, for a lot of the guys out there that watch the show do, this kind of a system can be really nice. Now, granted, we've got the top of the line, top dog, but even their basic systems offer you the same amenities that this has. This is just a little bit more Mac Daddy than what you get with the base kits. But still, it's all there.
Yeah.
So I really like the system. I think it's done us a nice job here, because what we have on the car especially, I'm not so sure I would be comfortable with somebody aligning the front end on this thing. I haven't found anybody around here locally I like. So that being said, I like what we've come away with on the front end on this car. Now, you know,
well, it's also a good system because you can, it's light, it's small, you can throw it in the trunk of your car, go to a road race or whatever, test and tune, take a lap. If you don't like the way it steers, plop it out, do it in the parking lot.
Yeah, and that's the one thing. We had a little bit of a struggle trying to go through and learn this thing, but once you've got it figured out in the shop,
it's
really not that bad. And I mean, they even offer kits for semis. I mean, I know you work at a Kenworth dealership. You know, they've got systems that you can run semis with. FedEx and places like that use their equipment. So This is not just a little mom and pop group. They're actually coming along and doing some pretty cool stuff. So I really like what they've got here.
Yeah.
This coming weekend, we're going down to the National Parts Depot All Ford Show in Ocala, Florida. While we're there, we're going to take the opportunity to speak with Neil Chadwick of Chadwick's Triple Play and talk to him about his new product that he's got coming out, which is a buffing system that, according to Neil, leaves no traces, something that I've been wishing for quite a long time. So do us a favor and come back and watch us every Thursday on Auto Resto Mod. Have a great week. What?